Howdy, Happy Campers. Thought I'd make this video and to show you people, if you have the protective film on your vehicle like I do on my Toyota Rav4 Prime, heck, if you don't have a Prime and instead you have a Ford, a Kia, an Acura, a Beemer, as long as you have a protective film on there and you need to maintain it, all right, this is the video for you. I'm going to show you how to maintain the edge. If you have to clean it or cut it, think of it like your fingernails. All right, either clean under it or you're gonna have to cut the nails off. The same principle is gonna apply. And if you don't have a protective film and you know someone who does, watch the video and amaze them how easy it is to maintain it. I'm not gonna show you how to wax it. That's easy, anyone can do that. I'm just gonna show you how to get this protective film back to almost its original way. All right, enough jibber jabber. Stay tuned and I think you might like the video. Alrighty here, Happy Campers. Just want to show you here real quick for some of you who might have had your Rav4 Prime for a while and you have a protective film like I do. Alright, or if you have some other film or vinyl, it'll work the same way. As you can see here, okay, after waxing a few times, you'll get that mark. All right, sometimes it's not seen as clearly. Sometimes it will be. But in case you wanted to get it off, here's an easy way just to show you. All right, for example, right here, we have the clear line. To take it off, that's all you need right there, baby. Just that. And real simple, because you don't want to scratch your paint, all right? And this film will last a long time if you take care of it, all right? Later on, just like anything else, when it wears out, this will eventually wear off. And you might want to start cutting it little by little, taking off a little section of it here as you go through, all right? So for right now, real easy, take your toothpick, take your time, and really just like this. Okay, you see it coming off there? See it right there? That's how easy it is. All right, it's not gonna scratch the paint. You're not gonna ruin the protective film, you see that? That's what you get out of it. So again, real easy here. Like that. See how good that tip that is? Easy, huh? Just like that. Take your time. See how it's coming off here? There you go. Okay, don't dig into it. Just kind of run it through, all right? Whether you go up or down. See that? Or you work your way up. It doesn't matter. Okay, there's no right or wrong, only technique. All right, it's only wrong if you hurt somebody. All right, so make sure you get one that's kind of new so it's not blunted on here. Okay, right on there. Okay, until you're satisfied with the work. See that? Just like that, easy. That's how you get it off. Okay. Again, there's hardly any pressure as you run the toothpick across there. All right, nice and light. You don't want to scratch the paint. Okay, here we go. See it coming off there? Okay. All right, same thing here. As you can see in the top. Do the same thing, just run it nice. There you go, see? It's
like that. And you could use this on your protective film, on the edges of the vinyl, or any place else where the dirt is accumulating. Just like that. There you go. You can run that once every few weeks. Okay, you see how it's picking up the dirt on my hands? Okay, so take it off. Just like that. Alright. And then what you want to do, okay, once you run it off there, is this. Okay. Okay. Alright, so here. And it doesn't matter if you've already washed a car or haven't washed a car. Same thing. All you're doing is just getting it off just like that. See it coming up? Here you go, see that? It's the wax buildup. Okay, again, away from the car. See how it's peeling off? I know you can see that. This is falling off. Okay. If you meet resistance, back off, don't keep pushing. Alright, and just like that. See? This one might be a little hard. This one I might have to actually cut the top layer. Like a little trim. With a knife, because it's under. Oh, maybe I can get it. Looks like it's under the protective film. So I might have to go step it up here. Level 2 maintenance and get under there. Alright, I'll do that in another video. But for right now, let me just get this off. Right there, see all that? See how that's coming off? That's what you want to get out. Again, don't dig too deep. Take it nice and slow so you don't puncture the protective film. You can turn it over if it gets dirty. There you go, pretty easy. Okay, how about the ones on the door handles? Like the cup holder, like that. You see it? It's plain to see. That you could see the outline of it. Alright, principle stays the same. Alright, again, nothing changes. You do the same thing. Get a longer toothpick, or this one is fine with me, but if you need to get in there, you could get a longer one, or just tape it up on the end and you could do it then. Let me show you. If you're hearing background music, that's because I'm listening to Game of Thrones here. Okay, just like that. See? Same thing, nice and easy. Take it nice and slow. Don't ruin the protective barrier there. Okay. Same thing there. Okay, there you go, nice and easy. You see it on the tip there coming up. Okay. Look at the bottom here. Okay. Or remember, you don't have to go this way if you don't want. You could always drag it across like this and go backwards. Or again, there's no right or wrong. Just a matter of choice. All right, clean that up. Alright, just like that. Okay. Okay, boys and girls, let me show you what we got here. When you had a protective film on your vehicle, whether it's the Toyota Rav4 Prime or any other vehicle, and of course the edges get bad and you can't, no matter what you do, you can't clean out anymore. And you need to take it off. Instead of replacing the whole thing, you just want to shave it off. Think of trimming like your toenails. You just want to get the top layer off and leave the rest. You know, why cut off the entire toe, right? So here, all right, I got some excess 3M clear. That's what I used to practice on, because that's the important thing. Practice, practice, practice makes perfect. Before you actually do it on your vehicle, and end up putting a deep scratch on there, cut a little piece, put it on here, just like it's here, all right? Two, so you can see. I'm doing it on two different tops so I can see whether I scratch it. If you scratch the bottom, then you know you're gonna apply, you've applied too much pressure. And that's why you want to practice until you get that fine touch where you're just taking the top layer off, all right? So that's the whole point of this exercise. Just like in the military, we walk through it, okay, do a dry run, and then do the actual thing. Here, nothing but a hobby scalpel, knife, scraper, whatever you want to call it, you know, for hobbyists. Blades, hobby blades, they're not expensive. You can pick these up at any Walmart or Hobby Lobby. Anyway, you can use this, or you can use a regular razor if you want, but again, this I use because it's a lot smaller, thinner, and easier to handle. All right, so enough jibber jabber. I use this type, like any card, whatever. You might have something you might not use, or you can use a ruler, it's up to you. All right, and just start practicing. You just want to get the top layer off nice and easy. Okay, we're gonna cut it just like we're doing the top layer. Well, let me work on this end here. Okay, so here's the layer. We're going to cut it off here just like that. Do it nice and slow and go from there. Okay, see that give? You might encounter that the same on your vehicle, all right? So that's why you have to do it nice and easy and practice, practice, practice. One cut here.
And what I do is use something like this. Or you could just use your fingers. You want to get that layer off. Yeah, I don't know if you'll be able to see that fine line. Let me see if it works. If it doesn't, then of course I need to practice, right? Try one end, doesn't work. Try the other end. You want to try to get under there, just as if it's on your car. And it's possible I might not have gone deep enough, because I can't get a hold of it. Okay, as you can see, that's not working too good. All right, that's why you want to practice. So let's try another cut. This time, right below that. And I'm going to put a little more pressure on the knife. Okay. Let's try that one. Okay, I don't know if you'll be able to see the line right there. Try to take that layer off. See that right there? See how it's coming off? Alright. Now, did I put a line underneath? I don't know. One way to find out is I'll cut it right here. And then take this off to see if I actually dug into the paint. All right, that's the best way to test it. So let's test that. Let's see if I put a line underneath. Okay, again, it's a matter of practice. I'm not the best, like everyone else, just learning as we go. Okay. Put that aside there. And there's our line. I won't even know if I'll be able to see it until I look at the video. If not, I'll redo it again. Get under there. Okay. Remember, this was the mark, okay? Just so you know, let's mark it. And this is where the line is. So this is where we're going to look. All right, right there. All right, right along there. And we'll see if we dug into the paint, just like as if we were doing it. Take this off, nice and easy. As you can see, the tweezers help better than trying to get it with your fingers. There you go. All right. Now, see the line right there? I can see a little scratch there. Okay. Now, is that deep? No, because I can see it's still fine. All right. Would that be able to be buffed out? Yes, it would. All right. I have no doubt because it's not deep. I can tell. Let's just say, for example, if it'll clean out. Okay, just a little alcohol here. Okay, a little dab right there. Okay. Alright, you know, you could probably wax that off as if it was on a car. Alright, let's take one more off. Let's see how deep this one is, okay? So let's mark it again to see where we went. here, and let's, again, you gotta practice, because if you don't apply enough pressure, it won't cut deep enough, all right, to take that section off, and that's the whole point of it, all right? So here, just to show you, I'm going to use a different one, okay? So this one, use a card here, all right? It should make us a difference, because a card is a card. Just straight on there, and here we go. Nice and light. Okay, and let's take that off. There it is. Okay. I don't be able to see it the same. A slight line on here. Okay. We're going to try another one. A lighter cut to see if we could make it just a little bit lighter. This is where the cut is. The last one. We'll see how deep we went. And let's do it again on this one. And I'll show you what I mean if you don't cut it deep enough. Okay, that was a light one. So let's see. There, you see how it's coming off? All right, the whole thing? Because I didn't cut deep enough. That's a problem you might run into. So you got to be careful. It's a matter of practicing. You could pull a little bit until it comes off like that. All right, here you could just press it down and then take the rest off. Okay, here's the last one. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. It's not as deep as these other ones. Okay, the first one, second, then the last one. You see it? It's, that one was a nice cut. Hardly any lines on there. Okay, just to show you. Hopefully the camera can pick it up. Okay, let's take a look at this to see how deep I cut on that one. All right, again, the more you practice, the better. It's that simple. And again, if you mess it up, it's not the end of the world. Remember, it's just like any cut on a paint, right? You know, you wax it, buff it out, and it'll be okay. You know, it's not like you're cutting into the bare metal on here. Nice and light. Here we go. Hopefully, it'll be enough, deep enough. So we can pull it off. Nice and light. Just like that. Whether that's light enough, I couldn't tell you. Let's do it again. Make the mark here and here. Pull it out, or you could pull it up. If you pull it out, hopefully it'll separate. If not, you might put your hand over it, just like it's on a car, like this, your finger, so it doesn't pop up, and like that, until you get it started. Then just pull it slowly. All right. Here's the last one. It's very nice. You can hardly see it. All right. Again, the more you do it, the better it is. I'll take a picture to show you. And hopefully that'll pick it up. All right, the first one, second, third, all the way up to the last one. All right, you could barely see this last one here. Okay, now I'm gonna put that aside for now and show you on a different one here to give you a better idea. All right, this is the same. All right, I put the tape here, the clear plastic, and we're gonna cut that off. Okay, it's right in this section here. Okay, in this one, you'll be able to tell, really, if there's a cut in the plastic. So, let's do it. Put it on there like that. Nice and easy. You know, again, use your hand, guide it.
nice and light. Okay, let's see if that works. And how it looks. There it is. Alright. That was the first cut. Okay, so let's mark it. Right here. And there's the end. Alright, we're going to cut it right here. And we shall see how deep we cut it. The best way to look is to take it off. And nice and slow. Just like that. Okay, let's take it off. See how it's coming up? Okay. In a way, that's kind of good. Why? Because you could just pull it up and press down on it until you can separate it. Just like that. You see it? Okay. You see how I did that? Pull it up. And then the rest, of course, you just iron it out. All right. Just like that. Okay. Nice clean edge. Now, here is the line. Just so you can see, I can barely see it. Actually, I can't even tell. Hopefully, the camera can pick that up. Okay, let's try this one to see how deep I cut. And then we'll be done practicing. And we're going to try it on the car. All right, there's the last one there. Again, you want to get a sharp. If it's dull, after a couple passes, replace it. You know, don't try to save 10 cents on a blade. You know, they're a dime a dozen. Get it replaced and change it. Okay, there you go. Take it off there. Pull it up like that. Okay, if it starts coming together like this, it's okay. All right, separate it until like that, like I said. And that might be the best way, actually. Why? Because you're not going to cut too deep. All right, because once you get it started like drywall, you know, it's easy to start. And of course, you can use, you know, push that out on the car and make it flat. All right, where did we cut? Right here. Okay, cut it right here, and I don't see any lines. So that's good enough for practice. Again, the more you practice, the better you get, just like anything in life. The more you do it, the better you become proficient at it. So we're going to get ready to take it off the car, that film, that's not salvageable. All right, we're going to trim it off, and we're going to get it ready. Even though I've just changed it, I'm going to go ahead and change it again. All right, got plenty here. You know, these aren't expensive. You know, I'd rather be safe than sorry. Get a brand new blade for the project. Like that, nice and sharp. And that is about it for right now, boys and girls. She is ready for tomorrow when we actually do it on the car. All right, so stay tuned. This is what I mean right here. Let me try to focus in on that. This part of the protective film, okay, no matter what you do, you can't get it off anymore. Why? Simply because it's underneath it now. All right, so you can lift it off, or like any surgery, you're gonna have to scalp that off. So let me show you how it's done. And here we are. We're gonna scalp it right there. We're gonna use my card, or you can use any straight edge, as long as you get a nice clean cut across, and that's what we're trying to accomplish here. Just not a lot, just enough to take the top layer off. Again, practice makes perfect. We're done practicing. This is the real McCoy now. And nice and easy. If you're kind of afraid or squeamish about doing it, then don't do it. All right, again, if you feel uncomfortable about doing anything, don't do it. Just like that, nice and easy, straight across, take your time, there you go. All right, now let's take a look at our handiwork, and if it worked right, hopefully it'll come off. All right, slide it down a little bit, because in case you didn't cut deep enough and you have to pour some off, you can. All right, that end won't work, so let me try this end. See that right there, flat. And got one that's a little more surgical here. There, let me try on this end. If it's a little hard to get off, don't get frustrated. Just take your time. Okay, I got a piece of it there. You see it? I know you can see that coming off just like that. There it is. All right, took that off. And let me show you the final product here, just to give you an idea. Take this off. All right, there you go. Nice and clean. No caffeine. That's it. Remember before what it looked like? Now it's nice and clean. Here, I don't want to cut it because I'm pretty sure I can still just take it off with this procedure. Let's try it here. Okay. I could get a little bit underneath. All right. But eventually I'm going to have to cut that out, but I don't want to do that right now. All right, get that smoothed out. Get this here nice and clean. And just like that, okay. All right, that's how it's done, folks.